on the air. Broadcasting from 200,000 watts of pure radio power. This is Talk of the Town with Henry Henry.
Wake up!
Waking you up with the information you need to start your day.
So wake up!
News, weather, sports, and more. From Wilmington to Virginia and every stop in between. You're locked on to Talk 96.3 and 103.7.
Wake up!
Now, here's your Hall of Fame host, Henry Hinton.
We've already hit 80. It is 80 degrees outside the Radio Ranch. Welcome back on a hot summer day. It is going to be about 94 for a high today. 30% chance of some scattered showers across the coastal plain. And chance of rain increasing late afternoon to about 60%. So we should get at least a little scattered shower this afternoon. Tomorrow is supposed to be 97 and no rain. Jeez, it's going to be hot tomorrow. Hot today, too. And then Thursday, 93, 40% chance of rain. There's supposed to be a front coming through that will cool things off sometime on Thursday. Showers and scattered thunderstorms. High temperature on Thursday at 93. We're going to be down in the low 90s and maybe even in the 80s by Saturday. So some changes in the weather coming. And, again, Greenville needs rain badly. Some other areas of eastern North Carolina have had it, but Greenville is dry as a bone. Really is dry out there. McGee and I played golf this weekend. I played golf all 3 days. I played Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Wow, I didn't know that. You didn't tell me that.
I hadn't played golf in a month. And then I went out and played Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. I played with you on Sunday, some other folks. And the course it needs some rain.
Badly.
They're hosing it down and got the sprinklers going, but it definitely needs some rain out there.
Mm-hmm.
There's a study out this morning that says, in terms of whether or not, you know, if I've been complaining about the over restrictive behavior of Governor Cooper, and the question is whether or not, you know, any of us are realistic about this, because everybody's so angry now that businesses have not been allowed to open. I mean, the most frustrating thing about it, of course, is the fact that he's picked winners and losers. But a study from WalletHub.com this morning saying that North Carolina, in terms of coronavirus restrictions, is the seventh most restrictive state in the country. So we're number seven out of 50 states. Coronavirus restrictions in North Carolina. We're talking about the things they ranked are requirement to wear a face mask in public, reopening of daycares, travel restrictions, large gathering restrictions, reopening of non-essential businesses, reopening of restaurants and bars, working from home requirements and restrictions. And these were as of yesterday at noon, or Monday at noon. So WalletHub.com ranking North Carolina in the top seven in the country in terms of coronavirus restrictions. The states with the fewest restrictions, be interesting to see how these states have done with infections. South Dakota is number one. That governor's been awesome. And I think the South Dakota numbers, McGee, Google this. How has South Dakota fared during the COVID crisis? Because South Dakota's ranked number one in this, Wisconsin number two, Oklahoma three, Utah four, Iowa five, Idaho six, actually tied with Wyoming for sixth, South Carolina eighth, Arkansas ninth, and North Dakota is number 10. So
as of Monday, South Dakota has a total of 7,943 COVID-19 cases.
That's not very many, but, I mean, that's a small state also. I don't know what percentage of their population that is. But
they had a big increase Monday, 567 test results reported on Monday, and the positive rate for those test results was 6.5%.
Hmm.
So now they have active cases, 829.
So North Carolina ranks 45 out of 51. I guess they also, they must have included the District of Columbia here. Yeah, they've included District of Columbia. So they've got 51 rankings here. And District of Columbia, by the way, right in the middle at 29. The state with the most restrictions is California. Only California, these are the states that have more restrictions than North Carolina. Texas, Colorado, Massachusetts, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, and California. Interesting that Texas ranks below us, since they had reopened, but they had to go back and close again. So North Carolina, if you think that we're crying wolf, North Carolina ranked number 7 in the country for the most restrictions for coronavirus. So I don't think that we're yelling wolf on this. 10 minutes after 8 o'clock, I mentioned last hour. This one makes me mad as I don't know what. The offshoot of the North Carolina Association of Educators in Durham, the Durham Association of Educators, which is basically a union for teachers, demanding, before they go back into the classroom, demanding sweeping benefits for illegal immigrants. What's this got to do with opening schools? Just trying to leverage anything that they think they can. I mean, I think, one of these days we're going to have a president like Ronald Reagan that comes in and says, fine, if you don't want to teach, don't teach. Like he did with the air traffic controller strike? He went, I got an answer for this. If you want to strike, you're no longer an air traffic controller. Remember that? So the Durham Association of Educators has released a statement denouncing the school district's reopening plan and calling for universal health care and guaranteed income regardless of a person's immigration status. Says we must fight together collectively for changes that will permit our communities to thrive beyond this pandemic and during this pandemic and beyond. Some of the teachers are balking at Roy Cooper's plan to reopen schools in mid-August. By the way, Durham Association of Educators not the first to use coronavirus crisis as an opportunity to implement a bunch of left-wing goals. This is probably where they got it from. The United Teachers of Los Angeles, which is an actual union in L.A., they stipulated the district cannot reopen until charter schools are closed. The local police are defunded. The wealthy are taxed more, and there's Medicare for all. How about that? The teachers' union saying they're not going back into the classroom until the police are defunded. I just don't even know how to react to that. These are our teachers. We're sending our kids into the classroom with these people. Just blows me away. 13 after. The stock market has rebounded pretty well, as you know. We didn't ever get back up to the pre-COVID levels, but it has come back pretty strong. But now a warning from one of the country's big financial gurus, Mark Cuban, who warns investors of that he feels like what we're seeing right now in the stock market reminds him of the 1990s dot-com bubble burst. Mark Cuban on CNBC on Monday compared the stock market's big run-up from its late March coronavirus low to the 1990s tech frenzy. He says in some respects it's different because of the Fed and the liquidity, but on a bigger picture, it's so similar. Everybody is a genius in a bull market. But don't get greedy. I've just never, anyone that says that they can pick stocks and know what's going to happen,
they
just can't do it. So Mark Cuban, who of course is a billionaire now, and it's funny, I've told this story before, but I actually had one phone conversation with Mark Cuban in my life, and it was before he became famous. I didn't know who he was. But you know how he made his money? Michael, you remember this, right? Because you were here, and we were one of the first radio stations in the state of North Carolina to stream our audio on the Internet back in, I'm going to say this was late 90s maybe. And there was only one way you could stream it back in those days, and it was with a company called Broadcast.com. You had to sign a contract with this company, and, you would send them your signal. This is so so elementary based on what's happening in today's tech world. But we would send them our signal on an internet line. Of course, and you know, the internet was very slow back then, but so, you know, it buffered a lot and that kind of stuff. But we sent our signal to Dallas, to this company, broadcast.com, and then they streamed it on their website. And so you could then put a link on your website, and you could promote that your radio station had streaming audio. We were the first station, one of the first in the state to do this. And we kept having a lot of technical problems with it. And I, you know, the guy who owned broadcast.com was this little-known investor from Dallas, young guy by the name of Mark Cuban. And so Cuban was running the company, and I kept sending complaints to the technical department. They would have a little, you know, thing on their website where if you're having problems, click here and send a message. And so I would send these messages to the technical department in Dallas, and people would get back to me sometimes. Sometimes they wouldn't. So I'm sitting in my office at about 6 o'clock in the evening. I can't remember why I was there so late, but I got a phone call. I answered the phone. Nobody was in the building but me, and I answered the phone. I guess it was the disc jockey was on, but I can't remember who it was. And I answered the telephone, and on the other end of the line, I heard this guy say, "Yes, I'm looking for Henry Hinton." And I was like, "You got him?"
Speaking.
He said, "Henry, this is Mark Cuban. I'm calling you from broadcast.com in Dallas." And I was thinking to myself, good, somebody's finally getting back to me. He said, I own the company, and I want to know what kind of problems you're having. Every one of these emails that you send goes to our technical guys, but I get a copy of it. And so I'm following up because I see you've had several problems here, and I want to make sure our people are taking care of you. And I had a nice chat
That's
with
good.
Him.
You appreciated that, right?
I did, but I was thinking to myself, that's how, you know, look, that's how you become a billionaire, right? That, and then he sold broadcast.com to Yahoo for about $1 billion.
Yeah, his net worth is...
How much is he worth now?
$4.2 billion.
Well, I mean, you know, when you got money, you can make money.
That is true. That's true.
So that was
Yes.
That was my touch with greatness. Just got a text. Somebody says, it's so sad that a lot of good teachers are being labeled with these left-wing teachers. You're right. That's absolutely true. It is a shame. But it is what it is. You see Nancy Pelosi's comment on Sunday morning television that Trump may have to be fumigated out of the White House. She continues this narrative that Trump, if Trump loses to Biden in November, that he won't leave the White House on his own. So a reading from the Washington Examiner this morning, House Speaker Pelosi warned that President Trump should be prepared to be fumigated out of the White House if he refuses to leave. What, are they going to get called Terminex or something?
Fumigated.
Going to follow him around, that guy with that little hose, you know? Get out, President Trump. Get out. Get out. You lost.
Next, I'm going under the house.
The California Democrat took a jab at Trump, who faces a tough reelection fight against presumptive Democrat nominee Joe Biden, after he declined to commit to accepting the election results during an interview on Fox News Sunday. Did he really not do that? Pelosi said Monday on Morning Joe, oh, there's an objective program.
Mm-hmm.
Whether he knows it or not, he's going to be leaving. Just because he might not want to move out of the White House doesn't mean we won't have an inauguration ceremony to inaugurate a duly elected president of the United States. So does she think that if he loses the vote that he's going to create a military coup or something? I mean, like Cesar Chavez or
I mean,
or Noriega in Venezuela a few years back. So Trump will be the new Noriega. I'm not leaving. You have to fumigate me. 20 minutes after. Let's take a break. We're coming back. More Talk of the Town here for Tuesday morning, July 21st. Stay with us.
Get a payment break at Greenville Toyota with no payments till next year. Plus, we want your trade. We'll cut you a check on the spot for your trade, up to 130% of book value. If your trade is worth 10 grand, it could be 13 at Greenville Toyota.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
Music for your workday with Mark, Mark, and Laura, Beth McCall, and Dylan McKay.
The most music for your workday plays here.
As the leader in heart and vascular care, Vidant gives you more. More time playing with the kids. More high school football games. Vidant is Eastern North Carolina's leader in heart procedures and patient outcomes. We have more cardiologists, more experience, and more locations, so you can have more of the things that are important to you.
Congratulations.
Like more college graduations. Vidant Heart and Vascular Care. More for life. Learn more at VidantHealth.com/heart.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Looking for a break from car payments? Greenville Toyota's got it. Right now, take a break on us with no car payments until next year. That's a new Toyota with absolutely no payments until 2021. It's the summer payment break going on now at Greenville Toyota.
Oh, silence would be nice.
Not a chance. Here's Henry Hinton.
Can't you just shut up?
Nope, not going to happen. Talk 96.3 and 103.7.
23 after 8 o'clock. Coming up, Ashley Nicole Russell. We're going to have Ashley Nicole on in just a few minutes here, and she is going to be talking about some tips for people. You know, it's interesting. You don't want to have negative comments about things, but people are getting divorced, and it's a way of life these days, and there's a better way to divorce. And so we're going to have Ashley in to talk about, Ashley Nicole to talk about that. Somebody made the point that I need to point out that there are 100,000 active teachers in North Carolina public schools, and NCA East only got about 60,000 members. But that number from 1970, I don't think they got that many now. That doesn't, most of the teachers that I know do not agree with the NCAE agenda. And I know a lot who actually disagree with it, so.
I don't know what the exact membership number is in terms of active teachers right now.
But, you know, it's a voluntary thing. You don't have to join it in North Carolina. All right, we got news headlines coming up. We got a phone caller first. So Latham is in Farmville. Good morning, Latham. How are you?
Good morning. How are you doing today?
Good. Thanks for calling.
Good. I was calling because I think it's time that, well, past time, that Republicans and people who are conservatives start speaking up a little stronger. I feel like we're just getting snowballed, and it's like Republicans are intimidated. And we give these nice little responses. I hear our senators and all saying, well, we don't think that's a good idea, or they shouldn't have said that. they need to explode on some of these things that are happening.
You want everybody to go full Trump?
Absolutely. Well, I want them to go full reasonable conservative values. You know.
Yeah.
And it's like we're just
disagree
saying,
with you.
Yeah, it's like we're saying, we don't want to argue with people, or we don't want to look like we're angry about things. We want to be really conservative and thoughtful. I think it's past that time, because we're going to lose our country. I mean, it's out there. I'm a veteran, and we're living on retirement. My wife's teacher's retirement. That's fine. That's going to stay the same. But can you imagine what inflation's going to be if we get a Joe Biden in and, we have to add all these taxes to support all these ridiculous programs? I think it could be devastating for our country. I think you just need to even forget about voting for any Democrat.
I think the problem that, we've seen the Democrat Party go through a metamorphosis. I have,
yes,
in my lifetime.
Yes,
because
me too.
Conservatives were Democrats back in the 60s and 70s, and then things
absolutely
have changed. And, now if the agenda is literally things like defund the police.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then,
yeah,
you wonder at what point, and again, anyone who disagrees with any part of any kind of movement can now be labeled a racist, and everybody
absolutely
agrees with that. You know, you've got
absolutely
a whole faction of people who agree with that. So I hear what you're saying, and I think you're right. I mean, but you're going to see it in this election, and that's what I said this morning. This is going to be one of the nastiest elections. If you think you've seen nasty in the past.
Yeah.
Wait till you get a load of what's going to happen starting about Labor Day.
But I'm just saying. I think we need to be nasty as they are. I think it's time to take off the gloves and stop trying to be, educationally and intellectually, just make these points. I think somebody needs to get emotional and say, we're headed for a devastating situation if we lose the election.
Don't disagree
at
with
all levels. At all levels.
Thank you, Latham. Appreciate the
You're
call.
You're welcome.
27 after. Let's get some news headlines in now. McGee's here with the latest. What you got?
All right. The Pitt County Board of Education voted on Monday to approve Plan B for reopening Pitt County schools in August. By a vote of 8-1, the school board voted to give families the choice of having their students attend school every other week with virtual instruction on alternating weeks. Parents also have the option of keeping their children at home for remote instruction. The deadline for parents to register their students for one of the two options is July 27th. Plan C is a semester-long commitment. Students registered for Plan B must remain in that plan for at least a full grading period of 6 or 9 weeks. The Dare County Board of Education voted 5-2 to move forward with remote learning for all K-12 students for the first quarter of the 2020-2021 school year. The Wilson County Board of Education Monday night voted that students will be at home for the first 9 weeks of the school year. WNCT reporting that Nuke's Eatery in Greenville will close temporarily after an employee tested positive for COVID-19. According to Nuke's Eatery, Nuke's Facebook page, through contact tracing, it is extremely unlikely the employee contracted COVID-19 at the restaurant. The location will be closing as of today to do a thorough cleaning and sanitization of the restaurant. Additionally, Nukes is ensuring testing within the staff and making appropriate shifts and scheduling to create the safest environment for its customers. A woman suffered stab wounds on Monday after Greenville police say she tried to stop the assault of a roommate with a knife. It happened at 33 East Apartments on East 10th Street around 2 o'clock Monday afternoon. Police say 24-year-old Jaquise Wright is accused of kicking in the door of his 22-year-old girlfriend's apartment and assaulting her. The woman's 21-year-old roommate got a knife and began to stab Wright in self-defense. Police say Wright was able to get the knife away from her, and then he stabbed her. The roommate received serious injuries and is at Vidant Medical Center along with Wright, who will be charged when he is released. And in an effort to mitigate further spread of the coronavirus, Raleigh Mayor Mary Ann Baldwin issued an executive order on Monday banning the sale of alcohol in the capital city after 11 o'clock. The order, which takes effect Wednesday, will include bars, restaurants, convenience stores, and grocery stores. Alcohol sales will be allowed to resume at 7 a.m. the following morning.
All right, very good. 29 after. Let's check our our news, our weather. Let's check our weather.
Something.
Let's check something. Let's check the weather forecast for the next few days. Today we're going to have some scattered storms developing in the afternoon. We could get up to a 60% chance of those here in Greenville. We need them badly. Going to be 94 and hot. You talk about hot, though, tomorrow. Hot, humid, 97 for a high. That'll be the highest number we've seen so far this year. And, again, hot and humid again. And no chance of rain in the forecast at all tomorrow. It'll come back on Thursday with 40% chance. And we've got that front moving through on Thursday, maybe Friday, 60% chance of rain. Temperatures in the low 90s. We might even get in the 80s this weekend for a high. That'll be good news. Current temperature outside the Radio Ranch now 83 already, on the way to about 94, 95 today. At 8:30, let's get a break in. More talk of the town on the way. Our friend Ashley Nichole Russell coming up next. We'll be right back with Ashley Nichole.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
As the leader in heart and vascular care, Vidant gives you more. More time playing with the kids. More high school football games. Touchdown! Vidant is Eastern North Carolina's leader in heart procedures and patient outcomes. We have more cardiologists, more experience, and more locations, so you can have more of the things that are important to you.
Congratulations.
Like more college graduations. Vidant Heart and Vascular Care. More for life. Learn more at VidantHealth.com/heart.
Mom, I'm so bored.
The most music for your workday with Mark, Mark, and Laura, Beth McCall, and Dylan McKay.
The most music for your workday plays here.
That she was up for adoption, she was dead set on, no, I need to just be realistic about my life and what my future holds.
That's when she came to me and she said, would you be interested in us adopting you? I didn't think that I would have a family again. I didn't think that I would go to college. I didn't think that I would have love. And with that, I just feel like my world is just so much brighter.
Sexy and I know it. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
This is Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton, a man who calls the ninth hole his second home.
On your deathbed, you will receive total consciousness.
Talk 96.3 and 103.7.
Okay, welcome back, 8:33, and my friend Ashley Nichole Russell is here. She is a divorce lawyer and an author. She's written a book, The Cure for Divorce Culture. She has a podcast she does called Divorce Healthy, and, of course, she's with the A&R Law Firm, offices in Greenville and Beaufort and Raleigh.
Yes.
And somebody told me they saw a new billboard for you on the way to Raleigh. Is it true?
It is so true, on 264 from Greenville to Raleigh. Big. It's so pretty.
I used to travel Greenville to Raleigh so much, I would notice it, but I did, you know, with Corona, we can't, you know, there's been no reasons to go to Raleigh.
Going to the coast. But, hey, on the coast, coming back, you will see the big Divorce Healthy billboard.
I've seen that one.
Yeah.
I've seen that one.
Yeah.
All right, let's talk about Divorce Healthy. And we're going to focus on, by the way, for businesses and the HR departments and businesses managing the cost of divorce. Mm-hmm. We're going to talk about that in a second. But when we had you on last, we were talking about divorcing healthy. You work with couples on collaborative divorce. And
Correct.
For people who may have missed that, tell us what that means. Because divorce can get very nasty.
It can.
But it doesn't have to, right?
It does not have to.
And it's better if it doesn't.
It cost-wise, yeah. emotionally, physically. So, you know, there are options. And really what we want people to know is that you have an option. Most people think you have to go get a litigation attorney, you have to go to court. Well, you don't have to. You know, explore your options in advance. There's actually a nonprofit website called nc-can.org, and it has all of the collaborative attorneys in the state. And it's really like a public service trying to just give people information so they can find attorneys. So I'm on that.
So it's become a specialty. If you if you want to have a nasty divorce, you go in this direction. If you want to try to work things out and separate the belongings and in all the possessions, you go collaboratively, right?
Correct, yeah. Yeah. There's like two separate options, essentially. Yeah. You're either going to settle it, you're going to do everything in a conference room, and you're going to do that with mediation or with collaborative, or you're going to go to a courtroom and let a judge handle it. And it's really it's a personal preference, but it's information. You know, most people don't even know that those are the two options, right? They just think that there's one. And so this is just really trying to help people understand that there are numerous options for you and just help us. We can help you do some homework. We can give you a roadmap. We can give you lots of information so that you can make informed decisions, because that's what we really want. When you're getting a divorce, this is everything in your whole life. Mm-hmm. You want to make an informed decision there. So make sure you know it all first.
Yeah. So what I'm interested in some of the things that you see. Do you bring the couples in together and sit across the table? Like
yes. Now we're a little bit more spread apart because of COVID, but a little bit more breathing room in there. But yeah, we all sit in the room together. So the two divorce attorneys are swimming in the emotions.
I was going to say, it must get tense from time to time, right? Even though you're trying to make it collaborative.
Oh, yes.
So how do you diffuse that?
Well, actually, I thrive in conflict. I just like my
you parents. Yourself thrive in conflict.
Like, I just do well in it, right? Like, I move through it kind of like the Matrix, and I can really hear people speaking past each other very easily.
So
and
you can see it coming?
Right, and we can help them kind of understand each other, because you build calluses to communication, right, and to people who wear on your nerves over time. You stop hearing them the same way. And so you need people who can help you see past that so you don't spend your entire retirement and college fund trying to get through something that truly you should be able to sit at the kitchen table. Mm-hmm. You build it all together. You know, we can take it apart together in a process that's kind of like a team building process. You know, we're going to go through the information together. You still have your attorney sitting right there with you, but it's not going to cost you as much at the end of the day, and it's not going to emotionally cost you as much. That dovetails into the businesses. Businesses are noticing how much they're spending on divorce.
How does it cost businesses money?
So subpoenas, they have to gather all the documents. They have to show up in court. You know, when you get divorced, a lot of information is incredibly discoverable. Like your whole life basically opens up like a big old book. And then everyone
can come
in.
So you find out that all those deleted text messages really aren't deleted, huh?
So many things that we think are deleted are not deleted at all. And so they have to produce all this stuff, right?
Yeah.
So phone companies are producing all this stuff. Banks are producing years of account statements. And so when someone rolls into the bank and they're like, hey, I need my last 5 years of account statements, someone's got to stop their job from the teller, print all that out. I've actually had a bank shoot a commercial for me that's like, hey, we really want to promote this because they're spending so much time. And then if you think about employees, if you're in an industry and you have 200 employees, 50% of them, that's our statistic, are going to probably be going through this. And then they're going to be out of work. I mean, a week-long trial is very customary. The build-up to that is going to be many, many, many times they're going to be missing work to deal with their attorneys, just to deal with the emotional aspect of it. And then think about, you know, this is one of the most traumatic things someone goes through. So, like, if your parent's dying or someone's dying in your life, how productive are you really at work?
Mm-hmm.
Take that mindset and apply it for 2 to 3 years, because that's how long it takes you to get through this process. How productive are your employees? Not. If they go through collaborative, they're in and out in 3 to 6 months.
So what do you tell businesses? I know you do some consulting with businesses and their HR departments on this. How do you help them get through this?
Well, we create employee assistance programs that help them to find resources that help them manage conflict with each other so that they can enter into a collaborative process and get through it. to help them kind of see the forest for the trees. This is how much you're really going to lose at the end of the day. You mm-hmm. know, are you really apt to do that? And so now that the businesses are starting to see that, I used to tour and speak. Obviously, that's kind of changed now because of COVID. People can't get together in mass gatherings, but we're still doing the Zoom conferences. And so I speak at HR conferences, and mm-hmm. I talk to, like, the people at Cisco who are trying to every hour, every dime matters. So as these larger businesses start to manage what they're losing because of divorce, it's a $55 billion industry in America.
Wow.
Like, obviously, that money is...
Yeah.
Important, and that's an industry. And so the big business industry is starting to understand how much they're losing, and they're starting to mm-hmm. apply that so that people can be more productive at work and also have a happier, healthier life, mm-hmm. and their children will be happier and healthier.
Last time you were on, I actually had some people contact me and wanted to know how to get up with you because and people have conflict, and they're going
they
through
do.
This. And a lot of people don't want to have a nasty divorce, but mm-hmm. they want to have a divorce.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll get to the information about how to contact you if people want to get more information on what you can do for them. But I'm just curious, you know, since you do deal with people that are going through a collaborative process rather than, you know, they're trying to work it out at the end rather than that. Have you ever had a situation where you've had a couple sit down and work through this and all of a sudden they go in the other direction, decide they don't want a divorce?
I would say my reconciliation rate is actually very high, and
oh,
I'm very
right?
proud
so,
of that.
So it
yes,
happens a lot?
A lot.
Wow.
I mean, I wouldn't say like we're not doing like 50%, but still
right.
a percentage of what the people who are coming to me obviously do not want to stay married. You know,
right,
so
yeah.
for any of those marriages to be saved is cool. And I'm not, you know, you can choose whether you want to break up or stay together. This is, you're mm-hmm. in America, you're a human, you get your own destination. I'm not saying divorce is bad or good. But if you're able to see what you have and communicate better because we're teaching you how to communicate, that's a big thing about what we're doing.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of saying, no, run to your corner, let's have a boxing match, put a big V in the middle of you and see how it works out over the next 3 years, and let's see how your kids are going to be in 10 years too. Should
yeah.
be fun.
Yeah.
No, we're saying, okay, this obviously is uncomfortable. Let's identify the elephant in the room, call it out, put it over here. Let's work on some actual skills to get you guys through problem solving. That's what it is. This is problem solving.
And they probably don't ever do that on their own.
No.
I mean, so they've been at each other's throats for years.
Yeah.
So when you get them in the room and start talking, maybe they maybe that's what
yes.
happens, right? They start to realize what they have.
Yes. And yeah. what we're really trying to do is build good co-parents. So even if, you know, you don't get back together, we do want you to be able to manage the business of running
mm-hmm.
your children. Because
yeah.
they still need you to function kind of like you
right.
never went through this.
Right.
That's how they get through this the best way possible. They will be fine as long as you're respectful of each other. And the litigation process loses that respect altogether. And it's very hard to get that back. You know, if you've been in battle with someone for 2 to 3 years and then now you're supposed to be best friends with them and put on the happiest face, that's not easy. And it's also understandable that people would go down into that. We call it the lower functioning version of self because you're in so much conflict. That's what your brain does. It powers mm-hmm. down and goes into flight or fight.
Yeah.
And so we're really trying to get you to be a more evolved version of yourself. Let's think
right.
with your prefrontal cortex, essentially, instead of the base of your brain. Because it's just, this is psychology. It's
mm-hmm.
not, you're not the most special person in the world with the most ridiculous divorce in the world with the most amount of conflict that we can never help you with. It's not true, I promise. You think it is. But it's not true. You know, we can help you get through
if you start to understand the psychology.
Thinks,
everybody thinks theirs is the first.
Yes. And theirs is the worst. And
yeah.
it's like, it is bad. And we're here for you. And we're going to get
yeah.
you through it. But it's not as bad as you think. And
mm-hmm.
we can help you compartmentalize it into a series of steps. And then it's a lot more digestible.
Ashley Nichole Russell, the law firm is A&R Law, offices in Greenville, Beaufort, and Raleigh. And you got a new office down a pastor office down in Beaufort on Lenoxville the other day. You've done a good job with
Thanks.
That building. It's beautiful down there.
Big sign, that
I've become
beautiful
such
wood
a
sign.
I've been become such a fan of that part of Beaufort. That's a beautiful little area there.
I mean, with the Beaufort Hotel and Bow Coast.
Yeah, you're right down the street from both of them.
I know. It's so great. And then from Front Street, too, we're so close to that. So it's just cool to be all over Eastern North Carolina. I love Eastern
yeah.
North Carolina. Greenville will always be my home, though. Greenville has been so good to me. You know, I've just never felt so loved by a community as I have in Greenville. Greenville embraces small business so amazingly.
Yeah.
And I love that. So I love Greenville, but
True.
The coast is so amazing, especially during this time. You know, it just feels nice to be by a body of water.
All right, Ashley Nicole Russell, the website is anrlaw.com. Mm-hmm. What's the phone? What's the best phone number?
252-702-4376. ANR Law is the website. Divorce Healthy is the podcast. And
how do you find the podcast?
So if you have an iPhone, it's preloaded. There's a little purple button on your iPhone, and you can click it. It says podcast. And if you just type in my name, it'll come up. Or if you type in Divorce Healthy, it'll come up. Right. Also, if you just type in Google Divorce Healthy, it'll come up on like Spotify. Whatever way you listen to podcasts, it'll be there. And if you Google, you'll find a lot of information.
And the book is The Cure for Divorce Culture, and that's available Amazon,
yes,
everywhere else?
Kindle, probably. Amazon. You can also get it at our office if you'd like to stroll by.
At what point would you say to someone that's thinking about divorce, you know, read the book first? Do you tell them to read the book first, or that you say when they come in and meet with you, say, read the book?
Well, as part of our we call it an orientation instead of a consult, because we're really orienting you to all of the processes. But as part of ours, you get a copy of the book with my firm. And then I do, anyone who's considering it or has a family member considering it, it's a great stocking stuffer. I mean, it's like, you should read it just to understand the historical perspective of what's happened in our country. Because once you understand that, it really kind of makes sense how this happened. It wasn't like personal. This is just an industry that evolved, you know. But now we have to see it for what it is and then kind of put it back into a place that functions. Because right now it's not functioning all so well.
Are we actually losing 50% of our marriages to divorce now?
Yeah, lowest 50%. Marriage rate of all of recorded history, lower than the Great Depression and both World Wars. That's where we're at
right
now.
I mean, and that's been in the last, what, 10, 15 years?
So as the marriage rate or as the divorce rate went up, it was like an almost, and the graphs a graph in my book. It's amazing. Yeah. School shootings in America, a lot of them are out of child custody battles and single parent homes, like 82% of them actually.
No kidding.
It's kind of, the book has a lot of frightening statistics, but I will say there's a lot of change happening over this country. There are a lot of people who have rallied together and understood that this isn't anybody's fault. It's just how we evolve. We understand that there are problems and then we address them. And I think that one of the greatest things we're doing today is as a society, we kind of see where things need to be fixed, and then we put our energy into fixing them. And that's really what my purpose and goal is in this world.
All right, Ashley Nicole Russell, anrlaw.com. Thank you. Great to see you.
It's so
and
good
by
to
the
see
way,
you.
Can I say congratulations?
Absolutely.
Congratulations. You're going in the other direction.
I am.
She got a Bailey box recently.
I did. So we're engaged, and Bailey's did an amazing job, and Keith custom designed the ring, and it's so
That's
beautiful.
Awesome.
A lot of people say, are you not jaded? Like, how are you doing this?
Yeah.
I think I've learned the greatest lessons ever about marriage and dealing what I deal with every day. But also, I want everyone to know that the thing that we want our clients to do is move forward with their lives. You know, I'm also divorced. I'm a child of divorce. And if you're going to make that decision, then you have to make sure that that next phase is better than the one before. So you got to put some work into that, you know, to be able to get there.
You kind of know the ropes now.
Yes, I do feel like I know the ropes. So we'll see. But I give us a lot. I would bet on us. I would bet on our horse.
Good for you. All right. Well, it's good to see you.
So
thanks
good
for
to
coming
see you.
In
and
this
look,
morning.
We match.
Yeah, absolutely.
Supporting the Pirates.
Got the purple.
Yeah.
All right. Ashley Nicole Russell this morning. All right. 8:48. We'll be right back. McGee's up next with sports.
Music for your workday with Mark, Mark, and Laura, Beth McCall, and Dylan McKay.
The most music for your workday plays here.
Looking for a break from car payments? Greenville Toyota's got it. Right now, take a break on us with no car payments until next year. That's a new Toyota with absolutely no payments until 2021. It's the summer payment break going on now at Greenville Toyota.
Top Dog Academy provides training services and daycare for dog owners in and around Greenville. The Top Dog facility, located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bellsport, is a comfortable, healthy environment where dog owners can feel secure about leaving their pets. Top Dog Academy teaches people how to have a better relationship with their dog. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
As the leader in heart and vascular care, Vidant gives you more. More time playing with the kids. More high school football games.
Touchdown!
Vidant is Eastern North Carolina's leader in heart procedures and patient outcomes. We have more cardiologists, more experience, and more locations, so you can have more of the things that are important to you.
Congratulations.
Like more college graduations. Vidant Heart and Vascular Care. More for life. Learn more at VidantHealth.com/heart.
Freshwater wetlands cover only 1% of the Earth's surface, but provide habitat for 12% of all animals. Why are wetlands such good homes? The plants, water, and soils of wetlands provide food and homes for mammals, birds, fish, and more. Sadly, wetlands are at risk, and that puts wildlife at risk too. To find out more about wetlands and how you can help, visit ducks.org.
While consumer use of electronics continues to grow, the environmental footprint continues to shrink thanks to lighter, less material-intensive, and more energy-efficient products. The Consumer Technology Association and its members want to help minimize environmental impacts by making recycling old tech devices as easy as buying new ones. Your old TV, smartphone, or computer can give new life to new products. Go to greenergadgets.org, put in your zip code, and find convenient drop-off locations. Live green, buy green, and recycle responsibly at greenergadgets.org.
Get a payment break at Greenville Toyota with no payments till next year. Plus, we want your trade. We'll cut you a check on the spot for your trade, up to 130% of book value. If your trade is worth 10 grand, it could be 13 at Greenville Toyota.
This is Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton. A man who calls the ninth hole his second home.
On your deathbed, you will receive total consciousness.
Talk 96.3 and 103.7.
It's already 84 degrees. It's going to be hot today. We're looking for a high today of 95. Tomorrow, 97. Woo. Oh, baby. Going to be warm. Talk of the Town brought to you in part this morning by Advantage Therapy Solutions. If you have not tried Advantage Therapy Solutions yet, and you've got arthritis or you're trying to recover from injury or you need pain management, let me tell you that this works. This is personal, comprehensive, effective rehab therapies that is done with whole-body phototherapy, and they can also do more concentrated treatment for injury or pains with the handheld lasers. Laser therapy is safe. It's non-invasive. It's a treatment option for many different conditions, and Dr. Matthew Wilding and our friend Kelly Brown at Advantage Therapy Solution can help you with many of your health and wellness goals. Call Advantage Therapy Solutions. They'll offer you a free consultation and a free laser treatment for every new patient. Their number here in Greenville, 252-689-8729. It's 689-8729. They're located up the street here, right across from the WITN studios, actually, at 212 East Arlington Boulevard at Advantage Therapy Solutions. All right, let's check sports headlines now. Here's McGee.
All right, the NFL is reportedly extending its players' union an offer of no preseason. According to multiple reports, the league is making an offer of zero preseason games this season, along with an acclimation period of 7 to 18 days for teams. The Southwestern Athletic Conference announced the postponement of all scheduled fall contests, along with the SWAC Championship, due to continuing concerns related to the COVID-19 global pandemic. Good news came out of the NBA's Orlando bubble. According to reports, there have been zero positive tests for coronavirus out of 346 since the latest round of tests on July 13th. And the Toronto Blue Jays and the Charlotte Knights have been in discussions about the Blue Jays playing their games this season. They're in Charlotte. They haven't had any discussions since early last week, but on Saturday, the Blue Jays were told that Canada's federal government had denied their request to play the team's home games in 2020 in Toronto. So we'll see if that goes anywhere in the next couple of days.
Interesting.
That would be interesting.
And baseball?
Thursday. Opening day.
First day of baseball. All right, that's our sports update brought to you by Beauty Bar Medi Spa in Red Banks Road here in Greenville. They got your back during the month of July. Also, your face and décolleté also. I had to learn that word, décolleté. But in the month of July, Beauty Bar Medi Spa is combining their most popular chemical exfoliation treatments that will make you want to show off your skin, so go ahead and wear that tank top with pride. No downtime treatment will leave the skin on your back, face, and décolleté clear, glowing, and hydrated. And in the month of July, Beauty Bar Medi Spas combining all three treatments for just $199. That's right, $199 for all three. Take advantage of this summer sizzler package by contacting Beauty Bar Medi Spa to schedule your appointment today. Ask them for the tank top trio. Beauty Bar Medi Spas at Red Banks Road in Greenville, the medical spa that has your back, face, and décolleté, too. At Red Banks Road, Beauty Bar Medi Spa. Check them out at beautybarmedispa.com. 855. Let's redo the laugh track, Michael. We had a Jim Gaffigan cut this morning on why we buy bottled water. Here's Gaffigan.
Try and eat healthy. I drink the bottled water. I feel kind of, and it makes you go to the bathroom every 10 seconds. But, you know, I feel kind of silly buying the bottled water. Maybe I'm just too Midwestern. Every time I go in a store, I'm always like, hey, how you doing? Yeah, I know I can get water, free from any faucet, but I want to pay for it. I'm just curious. Do you have any air back there? Or can I buy your garbage? It is water, right? How did we get to the point where we're paying for bottled water? That must have been some weird marketing meeting over in France, you know? Some French guy was sitting there, he's like, how dumb do I think the Americans are? I bet you we could sell those idiots water. Look, Pierre, the Americans are pretty dumb, but they're not gonna buy water. Oh, yes, they are. Let's just tell the Americans the water's from France.
All right, Jim Gaffigan, that is it for today. And by the way, that is it for Michael for the rest of the week. You're on vacation the rest of the week, aren't you, Michael? Michael, be safe. Have fun. We'll miss you. And Coach Carr will be in producing the show for the rest of the week. McGee, have a great day. Try to stay cool, will you?
I will.
We'll see you back here tomorrow, everybody.
Looking for a break from car payments? Greenville Toyota's got it. Right now, take a break on us with no car payments until next year. That's a new Toyota with absolutely no payments until 2021. It's the summer payment break going on now at Greenville Toyota.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and work week daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bellsport, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
As the leader in heart and vascular care, Vidant gives you more. More time playing with the kids. More high school football games. Vidant is Eastern North Carolina's leader in heart procedures and patient outcomes. We have more cardiologists, more experience, and more locations, so you can have more of the things that are important to you.
Congratulations.
Like more college graduations. Vidant Heart and Vascular Care. More for life. Learn more at VidantHealth.com/heart.
Music for your workday with Mark, Mark, and Laura, Beth McCall, and Dylan McKay.
The most music for your workday plays here.
a payment break at Greenville Toyota with no payments till next year. Plus, we want your trade. We'll cut you a check on the spot for your trade, up to 130% of book value. If your trade is worth 10 grand, it could be 13 at Greenville Toyota.
We do it.